5. Our lesson today is talking about representing data. This year we will talk about representing data by two types. The first here, look at the example number one. I have this table. The following table shows the frequency distribution of 100 student marks in a certain examination. I have 120 students and I have the marks of them in a certain exam. The student which get between 10 and 20 marks, they are 20 students. And the number of students that get between 20 and 30, they are 35 students. And between 30 and 40 marks, I have 30 students. Between 40 and 50, I have 25 students. And the students which get greater than 50 are 10 students. I want to represent this data by histogram. Number one, the first type of representing data we took now is called histogram. How can I use a histogram to represent any data? Let's start to draw a graph to represent this table on histogram. When your graph notebook, you have a paper like this. Let's first make our arrows on the first. Don't draw on the first. Draw on the second line. Here I will have something like this. And here also, don't draw on the first, draw only on the second. Like this here, and here. Set of marks is on x-axis. We talked before about x-axis and y-axis and origin. Here, of course, origin is 0. In the graph, we don't write x-axis or y-axis. We draw the name of on the table. Here is set of marks, I will write it on the x-axis. Set of marks. Set of marks are 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. I will write them here. 10, set of 10, like this. 20, set of 20, 30, 40, 50, and here 60. And here I have in the number of students, 20, 35, 30, 25, and 10. All of them are in table 5. So in my axis, I will move by table 5, starting from 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, and so on. This is called number of students. I will write here number of students. Let's start to put the data by using this histogram. After complete this figure, we will represent our data. Here I have set of 10 and set of 20. This means that the number of students get greater than 10 and smaller than 20, so are 20 students. So I will stop here at 10 and go up until reach 20. Here. Here is 20, right? So I made a line starting from here and go up until reach 20. Here is 20, so I will go move like this. Okay? Then you move, you make a line until reach the second set. Make a line, smaller line until reach the second set and close it. So it means that the student between 10 and 20, I have 20 students. Then the student between 20 and 30, they are 35. I start from 20 and go until reach 35. It's here. I stop here so you can complete this line until reach 35. As we do, make a smaller line to reach the second set and close it. This means that the number of students between 20 and 30, the number of students to get between 20 and 30, they are 35 students. Let's complete. The number of students get between 30 and 40, they are 30 students. Here's the 30. Go up until reach 30. It's here. So the line is already drawn. You can only do like this. Draw the smaller line and close from the other side. It's from here. I will put my ruler here to 40 and close it. The second one here, from 40, between 40 and 50, there are 25 students. Between 40 and 50, there are 25 students. Here, stop at 40 and go until reach 25. Where 25 is here. The line is already drawn, so you have only to make the smaller line. And close it. And close it. It's a bit clean here. It's a regular and close the line. The final one, the student get greater than 50, the marks greater than 50 are 10 students. So you get here on 50 and go until reach 10. 10 is here, it's already drawn. So you have to make a smaller line and close it from the other side. So it will be here. This you can see. The marks between 10 and 20, you get 20 students from the graph and from the table. The student get between 20 and 30, they are 35. Between 30 and 40, they are 30. Between 40 and 50, they are 25. Between 50 and greater, you can say between 50 and 60, they are 10 students. This is the representing data of histogram. This is when we said represent data using a histogram. This is the data using a histogram. Now we will move to the second, which is called frequency value. We have representing. The second type of this, it's called represent also. This is the same table, but using frequency volume for this table. Look here, we finished in the first example, draw by histogram. The second meaning for me, draw frequency volume. Frequency volume is a small difference between histogram, and we will see how can we represent it by using it on our graph. In our graph, it is the same thing. Draw y-axis, x-axis, set of marks 10, 20, 30, 40, and so on. Here, both the number of students are in table 5, I wrote 0, 5, 10, as the same figure as histogram. But is that in drawing, it's like small difference. In frequency volume, we have something called center of each interval. This is called the interval between 10 and 20. I have something called the center of it. The number of is between them. You know that, of course, between 10 and 20 is 15. The number just in middle between 10 and 20 is 15. How can we get it 15? We have something called center of the interval. We have called something called center of interval. How can we get the center of interval? Center of interval is equal. A fraction starting the starting interval, the ending of the interval plus each other. Starting plus an ending. Over 2. How can we get the starting of the interval? The center of the interval, starting number, the ending number, I add them, divide the 2. The center of the first interval, it's 10 and 20, it will be 10 plus 20 over 2. The starting plus the ending, divide the 2. This is the first interval, 10 plus 20, 30 divided by 2 will be 15. We said before, the number just in middle between 10 and 20 is 15. How can we get the second interval? The center of the second interval? It's 20 and 30. Of course, you know that the number in middle between 20 and 30 is 25. How can we get it by the center of the interval? It will be equal. The starting is 20 and the ending is 30 over 2. 20 plus 30 is 50, but 2 is 25, as we said. What about the third interval? Its starting is 30 and its ending is 40. It will be 30 plus 40 divided by 2. 30 plus 40 is 70. Divided by 2 is 35. The fourth interval. The first year interval. The first interval here, I end with 40. Then it will be the starting of the next interval. It will be 40 plus 50. It will be 40 plus 50 over 2. 40 plus 50, 90. Divided by 2 is 45. The final interval, interval number 5, it will be our start is 50 and our end, you will tell me here you have 160, but the set of max move 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, so the next number will be 60. So I put here 60 and I will use it in my interval. Our start is 50 and our end is 60 over 2. 50 plus 60 or 110 divided 2, it will be 55. Here I have the centers of my 5 intervals. Here I will draw then the center of interval on this and I will join together. So in frequency variable, you must find the center of interval and you draw the centers of intervals. Again, in frequency variable, you have to find center of interval, then draw them. Let's start. The first interval equals 15. In 15 here is between 10 and 20. Okay? I have 15. And go up from the figure here, from the table. In 10 and 20, we find it's 15. I will take the 15 means 20. I will take the 15. Finding the center of interval of each interval, we will make a small table to put this data inside it to make easily when we draw. Let's make a small table like this. Here I have center. And here, what about here? Here is the same, the second row of the original table. Number of student. Number of student. The first center was 15. The second center is 25. The next one 35, 45, and 55. 15, 25, 35, 45, and the final one is 55. I put here in the first row the center of interval. What I put? The second row number of students. It is the same number of students in the original table, which are 20. 35, 30, 25, and 10. And their total was 120. I will now draw this table. The center of interval and the number of students. Let's start. The first was 15 and the number of students 20. 15 here is between 10 and 20. So in the middle way. And go up until reach 20, so will be here. To join them, make a smooth one here, which is the first way. Numbering each point to me is on you to join them to this. The second point, 25 and 30. 25 here, first between 20 and 30. It's here. And go up until reach 35. So here, make number 2. This is the second point. Then 35 and 30. 35 is between 30 and 40. And go up until reach 30. Will be here. This is the third point. The fourth point, 45. 45 between 40 and 50 here, and I will go. It's 45 is on 25. 45 here and go until reach 25. It's here. This is the fourth point. The final point, 55 and 10. 55 is between 50 and 60 and go until reach 10. 50 and 60 here between 55 and go until reach 10, it's here, it is the fifth spot. I put now the points, then I will get my ruler and join the point. So when I am numbering this point, I make easy on myself to join them and join them to be correctly. Join 1 with 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. Get your ruler, join 1 with 2, this is 1 here and 2 here. Then join 2 with 3 like this. Then join 3 with 4. And finally join 4 and 5. This is 4 and 5. This is called the frequency variable of representing data. This is the called frequency variable. To get to represent by using the frequency variable. Any table, you have to find first the center of each interval. I find the center, I get, how can you find the center starting point with ending point divided 2. I found each center, I put here, and in the second row, I put the same row of this original table, and after making the table, put it on the graph and join them together. When you finish, you can, if you need, you can delete the numbers you put, okay. You can erase them, so you can easily, I lose.